here means like they are they having the, we are talking about annelids, so they are also having the cylindrical body as they as of nematodes, but an annelid's body is segmented, they having the ring around it, and they are known as annuli, annuli, annuli. And they are that's why they are known as segmented worm. Why they are known as segmented worm? Because they have the annuli around their body. They have the ring like segments on their body. So another point, they are free living. Then the next point related to the annelids, they having the two openings. One is mouth. Yes. One is mouth. Another is anus. And the next point is they have bristle like structure. They have the bristle like structure known as cheeti on the underside of their body. So these cheeti are actually hair like structure. They help in locomotion. They help to make the grip on the surface. So they having the small hair like structure, they are known as the cheeti, and that helpful in the locomotion. They helpful in movement. Example, leech and earthworm. They are the example of annelida. Then arthropod. Another category is arthropod. Arthropod, around 80% of the animal kingdom are of the arthropod. So means most of the animal, they are categorized in the category of arthropods. So it's a very broad class in which different type of insects are what you can say categorized, and around 80% means arthropod make up about 80% of the animal kingdom. And they can be, arthropod can be terrestrial or aquatic. They can be found in water as well as on land. The body have a hard outer covering. They are known as exoskeleton. Like we have endoskeleton of bones. Inside the body, there's a framework of bone that is called endoskeleton. So that's inside. But the arthropods having the hard covering around their body, that is known as exoskeleton, and that is proteinaceous. Proteinaceous means that's the of protein, that made up of protein, and the name we give to this exoskeleton, that is chitin. So proteinaceous substance that is used to make the exoskeleton of the arthropod, that is chitin. It's not chitin, it's chitin. What is it? It's chitin. Chitin. Okay, pronounce it chitin. And the body is divided into three parts: head, thorax, and abdomen. Here you can see this head. This is head. Then this is thorax. This is abdomen. So the body is divided into three parts: head, thorax, and abdomen. It also bears jointed legs in pair of three to many for locomotion. See, they have jointed legs. If you see this, the joints are there. They're having the joints. They mean joints, so that's why they having the jointed legs. Jointed means having joints, as it is very clear in this picture. You can see that the joints are very much clear in the picture. That's why we call their legs are jointed legs, and they are usually of three pairs. They can be many, more than this, more than three also they can be having the legs. And they have antennae also. Antennae, they are actually sensory organ, you can say. They used for senses. So they are the sensory organ. and they used for senses. Are you getting? Means like we have five sensory organ in our body, so they also have sensory organ that is called what you can say antennae. So antennae, they are thin movable structure and they present on the head. They are the antennae, you can see here. They are present on the head. Here is it visible? Yes. So they are the sensory organ, you can say. They respond to sense. So they having the compound eyes. The eyes are compound. Why we call them compound? Because they are made up of many lenses. They are made up of means many lenses. That's why they are known as compound eyes. So they have how many features they have? They have compound eyes, they have antennae, they have jointed legs, their body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Yes. Yes. Are you saying something? Umar, you raise hand. What do you want to say? Yes. No. Okay. So they have antennae, their feature. They have rounded legs. Their body divided into three parts. That is head, thorax and abdomen. Okay. And then they have wings. Some having wings, some are wingless, some are having one pair of wings, some are having two pair of wings. And this is the foreleg. This is middle leg. This is hind leg. The back leg is the hind leg. The front leg is the foreleg, F-O-R-E, foreleg. The front leg is foreleg. And the back leg is the hind leg. And the middle one is the middle leg. So they have usually three pair of legs. They can be having more than three also. So this is all about arthropods. So what is special feature of arthropods? They have proteinaceous exoskeleton, proteinaceous outer covering. Proteinaceous, they means proteinaceous exoskeleton, that is known as chitin. Means they have chitin on their body. This is a special feature. And I told you other features also, like they have antennae as a sensory organ. The body is divided into three parts, head, thorax and abdomen. They having compound eyes, and they having the jointed legs. So they are some feature of the arthropod. Example, scorpion, the honeybee, so many. All the insects are categorized in arthropod only. So now raise your hand and tell me some features of arthropod. And I'm expecting more hands, not to always like two, three hands. No, I want more hand to be raised. If you people are in class. Features of arthropod. Arthropod. Tell me then. Shifa, yes. Shifa. Shifa, yes, tell me some features of arthropod. Yes, tell me. Fatma Zahra, you tell me. फातिमा जहरा, फातिमा जहरा, एम आई ऑडिबल और नॉट? यस, माय वॉइस इज कट, नाउ एम आई ऑडिबल? एम आई ऑडिबल? सो फीचर्स आई आस्क्ड, फीचर्स ऑफ आर्थ्रोपोड, टू सो मेनी आई टोल्ड जस्ट नाउ, टेल मी टू थ्री एटलीस्ट. वेरी गुड. यस, एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ लेग्स दे हैव? व्हाट टाइप ऑफ लेग्स दे हैव? यस, they have jointed legs. What does it mean, jointed leg? Jointed means they have joints. Jointed means they have joints. As I shown you in picture, their joints are visible. So jointed legs they have, and yes. Shifa, I called you earlier also. There was no response. Am I audible to you? So tell me some more features of arthropod. More feature of arthropod. They have antennae. They have antennae as a sensory organ, and very good. They have compound eyes. Where are they present? On the head. On their head. Yes. So, what are the few features we discussed of arthropod? They have chitin. Means the exoskeleton made up of chitin. They can be terrestrial and aquatic, and their body is divided into three part: head, thorax, and abdomen. And it they have jointed legs. Jointed legs means they have the legs having the joints. They have antennae as a sensory organ. They have compound eyes. Compound eyes means many lens they have. As we having only one lens in our eye, they having many lens in the eye. That's why it is known as compound eye. So these few features we have discussed about arthropod, and there are so many examples you can write, because all the insects they categorized in this only. So you know, so many examples are there in your book, Honeybee and Scorpions. It is written, but there will be, you know, broad category of animals categorized under the cat under this category arthropod. As I told you, 80% they are, means 80% of the kingdom Animalia are the arthropod only. Now the next is mollusca. So the next category is mollusk, and an example of mollusk is a snail. Mollusk can be terrestrial or aquatic. They also can be just like arthropod. They can be terrestrial or aquatic. They have soft, unsegmented body that can be divided into three parts: head, visceral mass, and muscular foot. So they having here, you just see in this picture, they having the head. They also, their body is divided into three parts: visceral, mass, and muscle. Foot. Yes. So.